And it's great to have this longing to see Jesus. What a wonderful pure prayer that these freaks that have come to Jerusalem to worship at the Passover. He said, we want to see Jesus. Because this is what's going to bring us happiness. Just like the happiness of a young couple who gets a chance to see each other. They're madly in love. And the sight of their beloved gives them joy, gives them happiness. We wish to see Jesus. But for this to truly take place, Jesus recognized something else needed to happen. Unless the great weight falls to the ground and dies and remains alone. I'm troubled now. Yet what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, for this purpose I came to this hour. Christ is approaching his ultimate sacrifice on the cross. He can anticipate it. It troubles him. And yet, he knows for him to embrace the bride, which will include these Greeks that are visiting from afar, he needs to die. This is what's going to enable us to see God. For us to see God, to see Jesus Christ, Christ has to die. And Christ had this longing to offer his life to God the Father. Here he has this longing to be with us, for us to truly see him. And to fulfill that longing, that he must die. It terrifies him because he's truly man like you and me, and death terrifies us. Yet he knows, when I'm lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men, all people, all things to myself. I will gather all as my bride. Presents my bride to my Heavenly Father. United to Christ, we will see God through Jesus Christ. But for this to happen, Christ must die on the cross. Out of an act of love, so that we too will learn to die to ourselves. This is truly the pathway to happiness, is death. If you wish to be my disciple, you must deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. Oftentimes our Lord gives us purification. He sends us, or allows us, to experience suffering, because he knows we must die. And it's precisely in those areas we have the hardest time with. The attachments that we hold on to, that our Lord is asking us to give up. We don't do it voluntarily. He oftentimes will take it from us. Perhaps we're attached to material things, to possessions. And in order to be able to see Christ, we have to die with him. So what does he do? He allows us to lose our material possessions. But in doing so, we're free to focus on our Lord and give ourselves entirely to him, to be able to see God. Because now we're no longer just focused on our material possessions. For other people, maybe attachments to some human persons, that are keeping us from seeing Christ. And so, Christ may take that away from us, take that person away from us. It causes suffering. But then, we can see Christ. Perhaps it's some sensual pleasure that we, you know, we just can't let go of. And our Lord is saying, that's keeping us from seeing God. Blessed are the pure of heart, for they shall see God. And we can't let go of those sensual pleasures. So what does our Lord do? He sends us a painful illness to purify our sensuality. But then it enables us to see God. The pathway to happiness is the cross. Let's not curse the cross, but rather, let's embrace, first of all, self-denial, so that our Lord doesn't have to purify us because we have taken the path of purification upon ourselves. We want to identify ourselves with Christ. If He gave His life for us, and by this we know His love for us, we also ought to die for the brethren, for one another, through self-denial. We can embrace Christ outward in our own lives by embracing the cross of our duty, by doing our work and offering it up to God with joy. Then we will see Jesus Christ. Let's start with that prayer that the Greeks gave us. We want to see Jesus. As we approach Good Friday and Easter, let's just pray that a lot. We want to see Jesus. But Jesus is saying to us, when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all things to myself. Then we shall see God. We wish to see Jesus. How? If we stay close to Mary, our blessed mother, she will facilitate that. Because she will take us by the hand and allow us to accompany her to Calvary. Mary, we want to see Jesus. Take us by the hand to the cross. But don't let go, because we cannot endure it by ourselves. Help us to embrace that love that brought Jesus to death, that brings us to a dying moment of our life, so that we can